गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, आई एम अनमोल मैसी, पीजीटी फिजिक्स, माउंट लिट्रा जी स्कूल, झांसी। चिल्ड्रन, इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियोज़ वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट मेथड्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ इनडायरेक्ट मेथड्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट एंड इनफैक्ट वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड द पैरेलेक्स मेथड ऑफ मेजरमेंट इन विच आई हैव इवन एक्सप्लेन यू हाउ टू सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल्स रिलेटेड टू पैरेलेक्स मेथड. Now in today's video we are going to start a fresh topic which is errors. So what do you understand by errors? For this I'll give you an example. Let's say you have a table which has a length of 1 meter, and when you measured the length of the table, the answer was 0.9 meter. So here there is an error of 0.1 meter. How did we calculate this mistake? So this was calculated by subtracting 0.9 from 1. So hence the real definition of error is, it is the difference between true value and measured value. True value was 1 meter while the measured value was 0.9. So the error becomes 1 minus 0.9, that is 0.1 meter. So in short, errors are the mistakes which we do generally during measurement, and these errors are caused due to various other reasons, like it could be due to some external cause, it could be due to some problem with the instrument. So there are various types of errors as well. So basically there are two types of errors, as you can see on the screen. Errors are of two types. One is systematic error and the other one is random error. So first of all, let us discuss about systematic error. Systematic error, as the name suggests, it is due to the problem in the system. Now system comprises of many things. The instrument that you are using is a part of the system. The apparatus that you are using is a part of the system. Okay, then even the experimenter who is performing the experiment is also a part of the system. So any problem in the part of the system because of which there is a mistake in the measurement, that kind of error is known as systematic error. Now as you can see that systematic error is also of various types. Number one is instrumental error. Sometimes the instrument that we use for the measurement, for the process of measurement, could be faulty, and if there is any problem in the instrument, then there could be a mistake in the measurement, there could be discrepancy in the readings that you will calculate. So what is an instrumental error? Instrumental errors are those errors that arise from or that arise due to imperfect design or calibration of the measuring instrument. The best example for that could be a zero error of an instrument. Next is error due to imperfect technique. Sometimes the technique which is used for the measurement is not correct. It is improper, because of which there could be some mistake in the reading or there could be some discrepancy. So for that we are supposed to use the correct technique. For example, to determine the temperature of a human body, a thermometer must be placed under the armpit. But whenever it is placed under the armpit, the reading which you will get is not correct. The temperature would be slightly lower than the actual temperature. So that is not the correct technique of measuring the temperature. Hence there is some mistake in the reading. One more example we can take, that for example we are performing an experiment related to a simple pendulum. तो पेंडुलम में जनरली क्या होता है कि वी आर सपोज टू मेजर द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग, बट समटाइम्स इंस्टेड ऑफ हैंगिंग द बॉब, सस्पेंडिंग द बॉब फर्स्ट एंड देन मेजरिंग द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग, वी जनरली कीप अ स्केल एंड जस्ट नेक्स्ट टू द स्केल वी कीप द थ्रेड ऑफ द और स्ट्रिंग ऑफ द बॉब एंड वी मेजर द लेंथ ऑफ द स्ट्रिंग, विच इज़ एन इनकरेक्ट टेक्निक, बिकॉज the length would be incorrect. It would be slightly less than the actual value, while when you are going to suspend the bob from a rigid support, the string would stretch and the length would change. Hence the technique was incorrect. Next is personal error. Now personal error, as the name suggests, it is due to the mistake of an experimenter or some personal peculiarities. Example, like for example, while performing an experiment we are supposed to follow some precautions, but if in case we are not following those precautions, then there would be error in the measurement. These errors are known as personal errors. So what are personal errors? Personal errors are those errors that arise due to an individual's mistake or lack of proper setting of apparatus, individual's carelessness, or mistakes in taking the observations, etc. One more example which we can take, that for example, if you have a habit of always holding your head a bit too far to the right while reading the position of a needle on the scale, which will introduce an error due to parallax. So in short, systematic error can be minimized by improving experimental techniques, selecting better instruments, and removing the personal mistakes that we generally do while performing an experiment. In fact, to minimize these errors, generally we do not take one reading. जब भी आप कोई experiment perform करते हो, generally we never take only one reading. We take at least 3 or 5 readings, because while calculating the result, आप उसका mean निकालोगे, and due to the calculation of the mean, that many times the error would be reduced. Like for example, if in case while calculating the length of a table, if you take 5 readings, then while calculating the result, you will divide those readings by 5. So the error would be reduced by 5 times. Hence it is suggested that more numbers of readings should be taken while performing our experiment. So now we are going to discuss about random errors. Random errors are totally different from systematic errors. Random errors, as the name suggests, it is caused due to random mistakes for which the source of error is not known. Generally in systematic error, we already know that what is the reason behind the error. We know the origin of the error. But in systematic error, those errors could be rectified as well, because the source is known. But then in case of random error, the source of the error is unknown, hence it cannot be rectified as well. So random errors are those errors which randomly occur and they can't be rectified, as the origin of the error is unknown or the source of the error is unknown. Similarly, systematic error can be controlled, as systematic error, the source is, in systematic error, the source of the error is known. But in random error, since the source of the error is not known, hence it can't be controlled also. We can take an example for that. Like for example, we are performing an experiment related to electricity, and there are some voltage fluctuations. So this error can't be rectified, because the voltage fluctuations are not in our hand, and it would cause some error in the reading, but it can't be rectified as the source is unknown. Generally ऐसा होता है कि जब हम एक रीडिंग लेते हैं, उसके बाद when we are going to take the second reading, so it is quite possible that the same person who is performing the experiment might calculate some other reading second time. दूसरी टाइम में जो हमारी रीडिंग होती है, वो हो सकता है कि हम खुद कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, लेकिन पहली बार से हमारी रीडिंग डिफरेंट आए, बिकॉज द सोर्स इज अननोन, द सोर्स ऑफ एरर इज अननोन. देयर कुड बी सम अनप्रेडिक्टेबल रीजंस, बिकॉज ऑफ विच देयर माइट बी सम चेंज इन द रीडिंग. So these errors are known as random errors, but because the source is unknown, hence there are no types of random error. There is one more additional error which is also known as least count error, which does not fall under the category of these errors, but it is also a kind of error. So first of all, we'll discuss about what is least count. Least count is the minimum measurement that can be taken by an instrument. Like for example, if you have a normal meter scale, the minimum measurement that can be taken by it is 1 millimeter, so that is its least count. Now sometimes there could be some problem with the instrument, because of which its least count might change, which is not supposed to be. Like for example, एक हमारे पास में instrument है जिसकी least count होनी चाहिए 0.1 millimeter, but because of some reasons, because of some maybe manufacturer errors or maybe any other problem, उसमें अगर उसकी least count change हो जाएगी, so then the readings which we'll calculate or the calculations which we'll do would have some discrepancy, which we are not supposed to. So these are the various types of errors which we generally face during measurement or maybe calculation of various values or performing various experiments.